I love our love story. It's ours, only ours, and it's my favorite. And while I was trying to write my vows and think of some cute part of our love story I could tell, I actually realized there may be something I never told you. Remember when you told me you loved me, and a couple days later we were driving in your car to your softball game, and I asked you when you knew you loved me? Well, I think I told you I knew I loved you one day when I was watching you play softball, but what I didn't tell you was exactly how I knew. I was just sitting there in the dugout watching you play, and all of a sudden, looking at you, I had this overwhelming feeling come over me. And as corny as it sounds, I will never forget it. But that's when I knew I had just fallen fully in love with you. I'll never forget that feeling. I've only fallen in love with you more and more each and every day. You're smart, witty, quirky, and just plain adorable. I love how you're patient with me and others. I love how you accept me for all that I am and give me all of yourself. You're my calming presence, my one and only, my partner in life, my best friend, my forever. And so I make these promises to you today and every day. I promise to always value and respect your opinions and views, to see your side on all aspects of life, even when they differ from mine, as that does not make them wrong. I promise to always have that sarcasm that makes you laugh, and to laugh at your dad jokes, which I love and could never have enough of. I promise to constantly ask you to check the locks and to make sure there are no monsters in the house. I promise that every baseball game we go to, we will continue to catch that fly ball until we get one. I promise to remind ourselves of the little things in life, to continue dancing in the living room just because we feel like it, and snuggling up on the sofa with you as I warned you I would do for the rest of our lives. And while I cannot promise to be perfect, I promise to be myself, to always be honest, and to share my thoughts, dreams, values, and opinions with you, and know that you will listen. I promise to be your person, as you are mine, and to never take you for granted. I promise to always be by your side in sickness and in health, for better or worse, for richer or poor, and to grow with you, together, every day. And most importantly, I promise to love you unconditionally for eternity. I look forward to our forever, what life has to bring, and knowing that as long as I have you by my side, we can face any challenge, endure any life's lessons, celebrate all of our wins, no matter how small, and enjoy every moment. I love you.
Katie, you are the most amazing woman I've ever met. Your ability to love and support not only me, but everyone around you, has opened my eyes and truly inspires me to be a better person and hopefully husband. I look forward to a future filled with adventure and trying new things. We've already started building an amazing home together, and I can't wait to fill it with dogs and someday kids. But let's just start with dogs for now. Although we don't know exactly what the future holds, I promise to put you first through whatever comes our way. I promise to snuggle with you, even after a hard day, even when we're 80 years old. I can't wait to start our lives together. I love you so much.
forget these wide-eyed fears. I'm here, nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you. Let me be your freedom. Let daylight dry your tears. I'm here with you, beside you, to guard you and to guide you.
Our bride and her father.
You wanna go, and if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to
the door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile.
Should be good. Check, check.
Yeah.
Good.
Woo,
good evening. First off, I want to thank everyone for coming. It's amazing to see all these family and friends come from all over to celebrate Keenan and Katie. For those of you who don't know who I am, I'm Ryan. Keenan's older, stronger, shorter, and slightly balder brother. So I've known Keenan for almost 26 years now. I watched him grow from the little nerdy kid he used to be to the slightly less nerdy version you see today. I was there when he took his first steps and when he spoke his first words. Some of which he had a little trouble pronouncing when he was younger. One word comes to mind in particular, and that word is stick. S-T-I-C-K. Now, fortunately for us, how he mispronounced it was by replacing the S-T with the letter D. As in dog. So, you can imagine our reaction when he'd come running inside from the front or backyard and have to show off his new big stick. Let's see. So what else can I tell you about my parents' favorite child? Well, a quick little fun fact, in case you didn't know, just to outline one of his many achievements. Throughout grade school, junior high and high school, he was always number one in his entire class. And also in the top four in the entire school. And trust me, at Steel Academy, that is something to be proud of. Especially since Connor and I never even made honor roll. On a more serious note, being Keenan's older brother, part of my responsibility was to make sure that he made good decisions and didn't do anything too dumb. Keenan, I can honestly say, marrying Katie is the best decision you've ever made, hands down. Katie, you're always smiling. You have one of the biggest hearts I know. And by the way, you look absolutely beautiful today. I'm so glad that you guys met on Coffee Meets Bagel. I think it's safe to say you both met your everything bagel. Yeah. You both truly are the most selfless people I know. It's obvious you care about each other more than your own self-being, and that, I promise you, is a recipe for happiness. So Katie, while you've been part of this family for a while now, this weekend we get to celebrate it. I love you both deeply. Please join me in raising a glass to Keenan and Katie.
Yeah.
It seems crazy to think my little sister bought a house, just got married, and is moving in with Keenan. I'm not sharing any embarrassing stories that Katie thinks I'm sharing, because they're too inappropriate. We already know they're madly in love and make each other, you know, so very happy. So instead, I wanted to share a poem that sums up how Katie and Keenan feel about each other. It's literally my favorite poem, and now I finally have a reason to share it. It's called "I Carry Your Heart With Me" by E. Cummings. I carry your heart with me. I carry it in my heart. I am never without it. Anywhere I go, you go, my dear. And whatever is done only by me, done by only me, is your doing, my darling. I fear no fate, for you are my fate, my sweet. I want no world, for beautiful, you are my world, my true. And it's you are whatever a moon has always meant, and whatever a sun will always sing as you. Here is the deepest secret nobody knows. Here is the root of the root, and the bud of the bud, and the sky, of a tree called life, which grows higher than the soul can hope or mind can hide. And this is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart. I carry it in my heart. Now raise your glass for Katie and Keenan. May your hands be forever clasped in friendship, and your hearts be forever joined in love. We're so happy for you. We love you.
You can feel the love that's in this room, especially for Katie and Keenan, the two of the most wonderful children that parents could have. And we love them both dearly, and their future is extremely bright, and they will go through it together and have a wonderful, wonderful family, I'm sure. And if you don't, I'll be after you. I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. But at any rate, Linda and I both want to wish Katie and Keenan a wonderful life, children, happiness, and most of all, the continuance of a deep felt love. Because I really believe this, there is no substitute for love. We have too much hate and other bad things in this world, but I really truly believe that love conquers all. And I think a lot of people believe that too. So with that, Katie and Ken, we all say to you, congratulations. You're a wonderful couple. You will have a long life together, and we love both of you dearly. And with that, I will sign off and say, I'm going to get out of here.
Ladies, if you're single,
Single means you don't have a man right now.
Easy.
It also means you're dating, but you're not quite sure what's happening. It also means he put a ring on it, but nobody has said, I now pronounce you. You haven't heard those words. You're single. Bring yourself out here. All right, is that everybody? Oh, whoa. It's like I'm hearing footprints out of the woods behind me. All right, y'all. Last call for single ladies. Is that all of y'all? All right. Let's count down our bride from three, y'all. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Get her.